beds and tables and recliners. Whatever you need, this is the right time, and this is the right sale. And now, with any $500 purchase, you'll receive a free solid oak folding desk. It's perfect when writing checks, making notes, or while using your laptop or tablet, all while seated on your couch or easy chair. Made in America, we usually sell it for $95, but it's yours free with only a $500 purchase. But you have no time to spare, as our celebration and these savings end this Sunday at 5 p.m. Come in today. We're in Dedham on Route 1A at Route 95, or find us at westwoodfurniture.com.
WBZ News Time 1237. He was once the notorious boss of the Winter Hill Gang, now a frail 83-year-old named Whitey Bulger. Goes on trial this week in federal court in Boston. Bulger facing charges connected to 19 mob murders over the past decades, indicted in the mid-90s. Bulger fled Boston and lived for more than 16 years as a fugitive. The FBI finally caught up with him 2 years ago in Santa Monica, California, where he'd been living with his girlfriend, Catherine Gregg. Bulger's trial promising to have all the glamour and gore of a TV mob drama. Prosecutors plan to call a collection of infamous mob figures, including Bulger's former partner, Stephen the Rifleman Fleming, former hitman John Martirano, who admitted killing 20 people, Kevin Weeks, former Bulger lieutenant, who eventually led authorities to a half a dozen bodies. Divers recovered the body of a 10-year-old New Hampshire, a horse's pond at Wellesley. Alexander Glennon was with his family visiting friends in Wellesley yesterday. He went missing. His body was found about 30 feet from shore. In waist-deep water, he was drowning. And in Charlton, the 29-year-old man drowned while swimming in Buffalo Lake yesterday afternoon. The man taken to UMass Hospital, Lakeside, and Worcester, where he was pronounced dead. His name has not yet been released. WBZ News Time 12:39. Time now for Market Watch. Here's Andrew.
As more consumers use their smartphones as a lifeline, the art of conversation appears to be fading. A study by communications analytics firm Quantified Impressions finds adults make eye contact between 30 and 60% of the time online. But experts say people should be making eye contact two-thirds of the time in order to make an emotional connection. Strategists tell the Wall Street Journal it's especially prevalent among 20-somethings, text during dinner or check sports scores. Some psychologists point to FOMO, or fear of missing out, as a reason why young adults constantly fiddle with their mobile devices. Plus, corporate trainers say with more employees working from home, people have become accustomed to talking without making eye contact. In a one-on-one conversation on the job, holding eye contact for 7 to 10 seconds works best, at that in a group meeting. But too much eye contact can cause problems. At work, staring can come across as aggressive, and in a social setting, long gazes can be seen as a sign of romantic interest or just plain creepy. And Kate, MarketWatch.com on WBZ News Radio 1030.
WBZ News Time 1220. Forecasters say East Coast residents have a slight chance of getting a taste today of a violent weather system. It's claimed at least 14 lives in Oklahoma, Arkansas, and Mississippi, Missouri amid tornadoes and flash floods. On CBS's Face the Nation, Oklahoma Governor Mary Fallon talked with Bob Schieffer about her tour, the devastation in her state this morning.
The highway's here, clogged up, and so as I was watching the news that night and monitoring the situation, the highways were just packed. I-40 highway just had miles of cars lined up, I-35 down by Moore, where we had the other damage. It was right during the rush hour. It was packed, too. So I called our fire patrol and our local officials, our emergency management director, said, we got to do something to get these cars off the highways because they're in peril, because there were several different storm tracks, about 3 or 4 different tornadoes that were going through the areas. Anything like with the Moore tornado, but there were heavy storms, and these people were in their cars.
That's the situation out there. Meantime, 2 years ago this weekend, a part of Springfield was destroyed by a tornado of its own. Springfield's Mayor Dominic Sarno remembers June 1st, 2011 all too well. Springfield South End was hit along with several neighbors. The tornado then moved on to do major damage in Munson, Sturbridge, and Southbridge, and the M3 people hit hundreds of homes and businesses flat. WBZ News on 1241. Time for us to take a check on the weekend sports picture. WBZ's Charlie Bergeron is in the A State of Top Dog Sports Studio.
Thank you, Mike. Red Sox two better than the Yankees in the American League East. And Fox starts with the Bronx tonight. The Buckholz, who missed a start this week due to inflammation in the joint near his collarbone, tells WBZ Radio's Johnny Miller.
I'm not feeling good, you know. Like I said, it's sounds very muscular now, just from around the place they were working on. So, you know, the more I throw, it goes away. So that's where we're at right now. And, you know, pretty good.
That sucks. Starting pitcher tonight, Clay Bruins. Penguins play game two of their best of seven Eastern Conference final tomorrow at Pittsburgh. Last night, two goals within 4 minutes in the third turned a one-goal lead into three, and that's the way it ended. Cooper asked 29 saves in a 3-0 victory. Western final game two tonight in Chicago. The Blackhawks spotted the Kings in goal yesterday before coming back for a 2-1 win in game of that series. There will be a game seven in the NBA Eastern Conference Finals. Indiana beat Miami last night 91-77 in game six. Game seven tomorrow night in Miami in San Antonio awaits the winner. Revolution and Galaxy Major League Soccer 4:30 this afternoon at Gillette Stadium. Charlie Bertrand, WBC Sports.
I'm sick on the outside rough. How are you doing a little bit better, man?
Every 10 minutes, the News Watch never stops. WBC News Radio 1030. WBC News Time 12:43. Traffic and weather together. We begin with the Subaru dealers of New England. All-wheel drive traffic on the freeze. Nicole Davis, side of the road.
Well, right now, Mike, it's not rolling all that quickly. Try and get off the Cape. 6 westbound has a 4-mile backup back to exit 2 in Sandwich from the Sagamore Bridge. Now, 28 northbound have a 0.5-mile backup to the Bourne-Burgery. We had a crash on the bridge. They've taken that off. Some residual delays there are starting to ease. No major problems that we've heard of yet on the scenic highway or the Sandwich Road. Now, getting up toward the Mass Pike, you're pretty slow westbound from the Charleston Service Plaza to the 84 interchange. Otherwise, 395 north and southbound between exits 4 and 6. You've got road work taking up the majority of your lanes there, so expect some heavy delays. Getting back up towards south of town quickly, we have reports of tinfoil on fire, 24 southbound in the breakdown lane right after 106 in West Bridgewater. 3 southbound now slow approaching Derby Street. No problems on the expressway or the lower end of 128 to mention. North of town, everything looks pretty nice too. Downtown, the 8th block is still going on until just about 2 o'clock. So Sterl Drive westbound, the right lane is shut down at the Hatch Shell. Let's put you back up onto the Lever Connector inbound, pretty much straight over towards the Sand and Gravel Plant. Dorchester Day Parade is kicking off in about 15 minutes. Expect some slowdowns on Dodd Ave from Washington to Columbia. Summer vacation season has arrived, but before you hit the road for your warm weather adventures, put yourself in good hands. Talk to an Allstate agent to get the protection you need at a price you can afford. Find an agent near you at allstate.com today. Next report, 12:53 on WBZ's Traffic on the 3.
WBZ News Time, 12:45. We get a check right now on the into WBZ active weather forecast. It is brought to you by Bernie and Phil's Furniture. We've got meteorologist Frank Strait on the line with us. Frank, first weekend in June, and summertime has come in fine form.
Indeed, it has this afternoon with a good deal of sunshine for the short term, and you'll see it fading behind clouds later on. But still, temperatures set up to around 90 this afternoon for most areas away from the water. In fact, except out of the Cape, we're still pretty warm. Come from the Cape, the temperature's much cooler, though, with the rain influences there. We do have a cold front push again, and that's going to result in some thunderstorms moving in later on this afternoon, going into tonight. In fact, a severe thunderstorm watch up to the west of Boston. However, at the moment, all the big thunderstorms are still back in New York State, so it'll take a while before they get to us.